Hi guys, I'm back again after quite some time. I know I have not been very active with my vlogs, so I don't know if I still should continue in Hindi or English. Sometimes I think it's better in English because I think a wider audience can understand me, especially from South India. Anyway, coming back to the topic, so I'm going to Delhi for the Realme 2 Pro, I think that's the name, I forgot the name of the phone. So that phone is being launched, so I've been invited for the launch event, and the launch is on the 27th, so that's tomorrow. I'm traveling to Delhi today. I'll be staying at Delhi and then attend the launch event and come back the next day. That's the plan right now. Anyway, today though, I want to talk something about the SR150 and the new variants that have been announced just last week. So I'm not sure if you know, but the SR150, Aprilia and Piaggio announced a couple of mild updates to the SR150 last week, and very welcome indeed. But this is my opinion on these so-called updates and what I think of them. Do I plan to upgrade? Do existing SR150 users need to upgrade to this? And whether the upgrades are really that great? So let's talk about it. Starting off with the design. So as you might have already seen in some of the videos, the design theme remains unchanged, which is actually not bad because I quite like the design of the SR150. There might be some opinion, sharp differing opinions on the waspy front look, but then I'm pretty sure it's one of the best looking scooters currently available in the Indian market. I actually even prefer it to the Ntorq. I don't really like the front look of the Ntorq. It looks like a some sort of a hybrid between a Dio and the Yamaha Ray ZR. So on the design aspect, the SR remains unchanged, which is quite good. The two major differences that you would see with the new SR150 and the old one like mine is the speedo console, which has been changed, much needed. And because the Ntorq has a feature packed display, a much larger display, and it's feature packed a bit too much if you ask me, but then it's always good to have these features even if you don't really use them much, but on certain occasions you might find using it quite often. That was not the case with the SR150, because the only thing it had, as you can see, is the speedo console, the speedometer, which is by the way very inaccurate, and the fuel gauge and the high beam lights and the indicator lights. So very bare bones, no data, no time, there's no clock. So what the new SR150 gets is a new clock, two trip meters, an odometer, and an analog speedometer with 140 kmph markings, which is a bit over optimistic. Realistically, the SR150 can't go beyond 110, that too on a slope with good tailwind. Anyway, so that was that. And the speedo console is a welcome change. I really like the new console, even though it's not really as feature packed as that the one on the Ntorq. The next major change, I believe, is the rear suspension, which is now adjustable. So a lot of SR150 users might like this. I'm not sure if the old ones can be upgraded to this new thing. I even have plans to upgrade to the new speedo console once it comes to the showrooms. So let me see if that is possible with the, if I can somehow retrofit the new speedo console on the old SR150. Again, we have a traffic jam here. I think I'll speak to you in a while after I negotiate this really bad traffic jam. Okay, so I was talking about the suspension on the SR150, and I am yet to ride the new version, so I don't really know how good or bad the new suspension is, but I'm assuming it should be slightly better than the one on the stock, the old SR150. Yeah, so these are the changes to the new SR150, and yeah, the new color schemes, the three variants. So now you get the SR150 Carbon, which is the limited edition. We have the stock, the normal SR150 with new color schemes. I don't really like that blue color option which the new bike comes in. And we have the SR150 Race, which now comes with a windshield, a proper charger at the rear, instead of a wire hanging out of the battery compartment, which is very it looked very bad when compared to the more refined and better looking charger contraption on the Ntorq and other bikes. So now we have a proper mobile charger inside the luggage compartment, the under seat box. And now it's not an accessory with the SR150 Race, it comes as a stock thing. Oh yeah, I forgot about the connectivity options that the SR150 and the Vespa range now gets. So they now have an app that is not as feature rich as the one on the Ntorq, but now you can track your vehicle if you forget it inside a parking lot. I think there's a GPS tracker as well, which is quite helpful. So you have that, and you can even track your rides, I believe, and you can there's an emergency button using which you can alert your loved ones of any danger in case you are in need of any help, or you find yourself in an emergency situation. So you have that kind of connectivity option on the Aprilia. Anyway, so that was that, the major highlights of the new features on the SR150. Now I need to talk about the things I don't really like about the new bikes. So I would have really liked Aprilia to have given the bikes a better speedo console instead of the digital analog meter that we see now. I would have really liked the full digital console, although there might be people who might disagree with me. I think it's always better to have an all digital console. It's just simply easier to read the speed markings. Secondly, they should have given a better gas charge shock absorber instead of the preload adjustable ones that it gets now. Then I think the connectivity options should have been a bit more comprehensive to at least match the Ntorq. That was another thing. The major gripe I have with the SR150, the new ones, is that the mechanicals remain unchanged. So the power output and the torque remain the same, so that remains unchanged. I would have liked them to give a power bump to the scooter because it is quite close right now. If you check, the Ntorq makes around 9.4 bhp or 9.5 PS of power and a little over 10 Nm of torque, which is actually quite close to the figures on the SR150 as well. So the SR150 makes around 10.06 bhp, marginally better than the Ntorq, and the torque figures are almost identical. So not really much difference between the 125 and the 150. So, and if you recall, the SR150 actually weighs a few kgs more. So it's around 122 kgs, unlike the Ntorq, which is just 116. One of the most frequently seen comments that I've seen on my drag race video is people asking me why I compared a 125cc to a 150 scooter. It's unfair, right? But these people don't seem to remember the fact that the power figures of both the scooters are not really that far apart. So it's 9.4 for the Ntorq and it's 10.06 for the Aprilia. And like I said, the Aprilia weighs more, so I was really curious how much of a difference that would make. So yeah, I was talking about the power output on the Aprilia. So I would have really loved if they had increased the power output to say 11.6 bhp, which is actually the power output on the Vespas. The 150cc Vespas actually are more powerful than the SR150s, but the SR150 still tops out on the top speed aspect because of the larger wheels, I guess, and the gear ratios. So I would have really loved Aprilia to at least give us an option of a more powerful scooter, because the Ntorq and the Aprilia SR150 are almost on par when it comes to performance. Yeah, the Aprilia is faster by a slight margin, yes it is, but then I would have loved the gap to have an increase. So yeah, that was a list of things I would have loved Aprilia to have done with the new SR150s. And yeah, the big question to answer, should you upgrade to the new SR150? Not really. What you can check, however, is to find out whether you can change, can upgrade to the new suspension and the new speedo console and get the connectivity options, which I think is around for $1,800, which is not bad. So if you can really get these options on your old SR150, there's not really a compelling reason to upgrade to a new bike. So yeah, I hope that answers all your queries about the new SR150. I'll continue my journey to the airport and probably make a separate vlog on that. But the priority right now is to get through this horrible traffic. I think I'm through the worst part of the traffic jam, and it should be all clear from now. Hopefully there's a big junction ahead, and I am assuming I should encounter some traffic there as well. Anyway, in case you're not from Hyderabad, when I exit this underpass, you'll see IKEA. See, that's IKEA, the first IKEA showroom in India. So that was my thoughts about the new Aprilia SR150. And should you buy it? Yeah, if you are looking for a powerful scooter and you have the budget, then sure, the Aprilia SR150 is the most powerful scooter by a slight margin, albeit, in India. So yeah, you should go ahead and buy it. Anyway guys, hopefully you like this video, and I'll make a separate vlog while I continue my journey to the airport. Hopefully I should be there in a little less than an hour from now, unless I encounter some really bad traffic like the one you see in front of me now. Anyway, so thanks for watching guys, bye.